Good evening, Dr. Phil here. Today we'll be discussing on natural opiates. Opioid classification, pharmacokinetics, receptors and pharmacodynamics has been discussed in previous videos. Morphine. Structure. The structure of morphine was determined in 1902. Morphine is a phenanthrene derivative. It has two planar rings and two aliphatic ring structures, which occupy a plane roughly at right angles to the rest of the molecule. The free hydroxyl on the benzene ring that is linked by two carbon atoms to a nitrogen atom is the most important part of the molecule for opioid activity. Substitution at one or both of the hydroxyls produces other opioids, such as diamorphine, 3,6-diacetylmorphine, codeine, 3-methoxymorphine, or oxycodone, dihydrohydroxycodone. Routes of administration of morphine: oral, rectal, topical, intravenous, intramuscular, neuraxial, buccal, etc. Regarding the oral route, morphine is available as an immediate release liquid, tablet, or modified release preparation. Bioavailability is unpredictable. Oral route is often used to treat chronic pain. Regarding the intravenous route, morphine is commonly given via IV route to treat acute pain. For neuraxial route, morphine produces very effective analgesia when administered intrathecally or epidurally. Bioavailability for intravenous or intramuscular route is 100%. Oral bioavailability is 20 to 40%. Some authors report 35 to 75%. It is dependent on first-pass hepatic metabolism. Bioavailability via oral route is unpredictable. Rectal route bioavailability is 35 to 70%. Metabolism of morphine. Morphine is metabolized by microsomal UDP glucuronyl transferases found in the liver, kidney, and intestines. Metabolites from conjugation of morphine includes morphine-3-glucuronide and morphine-6-glucuronide. M3G is the main metabolite in humans, consists of 60 to 80%. M3G may have an excitatory effect via CNS actions not related to opioid receptor activation. M3G has little or no affinity for opioid receptors. Regarding morphine-6-glucuronide, 10% of morphine is metabolized to M6G. This is a full agonist at the MOP receptor, producing analgesia and other MOP-related effects. It is 650 times more potent than morphine. At the concentrations observed following morphine administration in a patient with normal renal function, M6G's contribution to the overall analgesic effect is minimal. M6G has low lipophilicity. Passage of M6G across the blood-brain barrier is slow and limited. Transport of M3G and M6G out of the hepatocytes. Most are transported back to the bloodstream via transporter protein MRP3 in hepatocytes. However, a small portion is transported into the bile ducts via transporter protein MRP2. Involvement of the enterohepatic cycle in morphine metabolism. M3G and M6G transported into the bile reach the gut, where both glucuronides are deglucuronidated and the resultant morphine molecule is partially absorbed by enterocytes. Enterocytes are also able to metabolize morphine to M3G and M6G. Enterocytes transports M3G, M6G, and morphine to the bloodstream via enterohepatic cycle. Metabolism of morphine is impaired in neonates. Neonates have low conjugating capacity, and morphine or morphine-like drugs have a much longer duration of action, and there is a higher risk of causing respiratory depression and sedation. Thus, morphine cogeners should not be used in the neonatal period or used as analgesic during childbirth. Pethidine is a safer alternative. Plasma half-life of morphine is 3 to 4 hours. Reduction in morphine plasma concentration after initial distribution is principally due to metabolism because only a small amount of unchanged opioid is excreted in the urine. Morphine excretion. After glucuronidation, more than 90% of morphine metabolites are excreted in the urine. Metabolites may accumulate in patients with impaired renal function, causing respiratory depression and sedation. Accumulation of morphine metabolites, particularly M6G, becomes significant when creatinine clearance declines to less than 50 mL per minute. The rest of the metabolites are excreted in the bowel and reabsorbed via the enterohepatic circulation. Onset of analgesia is 15 to 30 minutes, duration of analgesia 4 to 6 hours. Time to peak effect. It takes 1 to 2 hours to reach peak effect. Morphine dosing for postoperative pain control in adults, taking into account the long time to peak analgesia. Administer an initial morphine bolus dose 0.15 to 0.2 mg per kg at least 60 minutes before the end of surgery. If the patient is in pain in the post-anesthesia care unit, administer 2 mg bolus doses at 5 to 10 minute intervals until visual analog pain scores decrease to less than 30 on a scale from 0 to 100. Patient control analgesia pump may be started. Multimodal analgesia with opioid-sparing drugs should be administered. If the patient is still in pain despite large doses of morphine, consider administering ketamine or an alpha-2 adrenergic receptor agonist. Kindly refer to the opioid tolerance section in the opioid pharmacodynamics video for further details. Other PK parameters, pKa of morphine is 7.9, protein binding 30%, octanol water partition coefficient is 6, clearance of morphine is 15 to 20 mL per kg per minute, volume of distribution 3 to 5 liters per minute. Terminal half-life and duration of action has been mentioned. Main adverse effects of morphine includes sedation, respiratory depression, constipation, nausea and vomiting, itch from histamine release, tolerance and dependence, euphoria. Morphine is mainly used for treatment of acute and chronic pain and for sedation. Dosage. The dose should be titrated to effect. The dose for morphine for breakthrough pain is about 1/6 of the total daily dose. Reduction in dosage and or frequency of administration at extremes of age and in renal or hepatic failure. Morphine administration in liver disease. Advanced liver disease may prolong the half-life and potentiates morphine's clinical effects. Monitor the patient for sedation. The parent drug may not be readily converted to metabolites. Increase the dosing interval by twice the usual time period. Morphine administration in renal disease. Use cautiously and adjust the dose. For GFR of more than 50 mL per minute, allow 100% of normal dose. For GFR of 10 to 50 mL per minute, use 50 to 75% of normal dose. For GFR of less than 10 mL per minute, use 25 to 50% of normal dose. In patients on dialysis, use cautiously and monitor the patient for rebound pain effect, or do not use morphine. Metabolites can accumulate, causing increased therapeutic and adverse effects. Both parent drug and metabolites can be removed by dialysis. Watch out for rebound pain effect. Intramuscular morphine. For single doses, the relative potency of oral versus intramuscular morphine is 1 to 6. With repeated regular administration, this ratio becomes approximately 1 to 3. Standard IM, IV or subcutaneous dose is 0.1 to 0.15 mg per kg, titrate to effect. For IVI dosage of morphine, for ventilated neonate, 10 to 30 mcg per kg per hour, for ventilated child or adult, 20 to 80 mcg per kg per hour. Oral dose in adult, 10 to 20 mg increased slowly up to 200 mg for hourly. Sustained release preparation from 10 mg BD onwards. For children, slow-release formulation, 0.6 mg per kg 12 hourly via oral route and increase every 48 hours if required. PCA dose via IV route. Adult, typically 1 mg bolus with 5-minute lockout time and no continuous infusion. Concentration, 1 mg per ml. Basal rate, not recommended for opioid-naive patients. For chronic opioid consumers, 0 to 2 mg per hour. Bolus dose, 1 to 2 mg. Bolus interval, 5 to 10 minutes. For children, PCA dose, 20 mcg per kg per bolus with 5-minute lockout time with 5 mcg per kg per hour background infusion. Equianalgesic dose for IV morphine 10 mg. Morphine remains the standard against which new analgesics are assessed. IV morphine 10 mg is equivalent to oral morphine 20 to 30 mg, oral petidine 300 mg, oral oxycodone 20 to 30 mg, oral hydromorphone 7.5 mg, oral methadone 20 mg, and oral codeine 200 mg. IV morphine 10 mg is equivalent to IV petidine 100 mg, IV oxycodone 15 mg, IV fentanyl 100 mcg, IV hydromorphone 1.5 mg, and IV methadone 1 to 10 mg. Other opiates. Codeine is also produced semi-synthetically and shall be discussed under semi-synthetic opiates. Thebaine is a pentacyclic opiate alkaloid intermediate in the biosynthesis of morphine by the opium poppy Papaver somniferum. It is used as a precursor for the synthesis of several drugs, including oxycodone, naltrexone, naloxone, and buprenorphine. Papaverine. This is a benzyl-lisoquinoline opium alkaloid. Routes of administration, oral, IV, or intra-arterial. Metabolism is hepatic, excretion is renal, half-life is 30 to 120 minutes. Mechanism of action, it probably acts as a phosphodiesterase inhibitor. It is a smooth muscle spasmolytic, producing generalized smooth muscle relaxation, resulting in vasodilation, GI sphincter relaxation, bronchiolar muscle relaxation, and depressed myocardium. It causes increased cerebral blood flow. Clinical uses of papaverine. It is used to treat various vascular spasms associated with smooth muscle spasms, which occurs in myocardial infarction, angina, peripheral and pulmonary embolism, peripheral vascular disease, cerebral angiospastic states, visceral spasms, and accidental intra-arterial injection of thiopental. Off-label uses includes intra-arterial papaverine for treatment of cerebral vasospasm resulting from mechanical thrombectomy in acute ischemic stroke. In patients undergoing CABG surgery, intraluminal papaverine has been used to prevent or treat spasm after left internal mammary artery dissection when delivered to the pedicle. Papaveritum is rarely used now. It consists of a mixture of morphine hydrochloride, codeine hydrochloride, and papaverine hydrochloride. Narcotin has been removed due to genotoxicity. No oral preparation exists for papaveritum. Dosage. Many anesthetists has abandoned papaveritum in favor of morphine due to its confusing dosage. The dose is 7.7 to 15.4 mg subcut IM or IV 4 hourly as required. A dose of 15.4 mg of papaveritum equates to 10 mg of anhydrous morphine. Narcotin is a crystalline alkaloid found in opium and has several properties such as antispasmodic and antitussive actions. It has no narcotic properties. It is genotoxic. Narcine is another opiate. It is a bitter crystalline narcotic amphoteric alkaloid found in opium and also obtainable from narcotin. It has a weak morphine-like action. It is not much used in medicine. It may be administered in a pill as a mild hypnotic and to reduce cough. These are my references. Thank you.